the COVID-19 itself is very shocking, because murder in the cathedral, murder itself is a significant word here. We say murder, but the murder happens to a great man, Thomas Becket. So murder, and there is another word, assassination, and there is another word, martyrdom. Here, actually, D.S. Eliot wants to talk about martyrdom, but what happens, he uses the word murder, which happens to be an ordinary man. So what is murder? Murder that happens to an ordinary man. Assassination is happening to a political heavyweight, and martyrdom happens only in the area of ecclesiastical sacrifice. Actually, martyrdom is a kind of sacrifice. So, in order to shock the audience, he uses the word murder. So, the very word murder is a shock, because it is not actually murder, it is martyrdom. But Thomas, Eliot, uses the word murder. So, murder in the cathedral. Cathedral actually is the church of the big size. So, what happens? Modern the cathedral, the title itself is very shocking, and so he uses the word desolate. So, next. So, actually, modern the cathedral is written by D.S. Eliot. The expansion is Thomas Chalmers Eliot. Actually, the play was written at the request of to be played in Canterbury Festival in June 1935. Actually, the happening take place only in the 12th century, actually December 1170. So what happens? T.S. Eliot, a Nobel laureate, T.S. Eliot writes this play for a church function. So he wants to recreate, he wants to talk about the relevance of martyrdom. So the central idea of the play is relevance of martyrdom. Some of the main characters are actually the play is consisted of very few limited characters. Some of them are a kind of group characters like the warriors, tenders, knights, and all. And Thomas Becket is almost the hero. And sometimes they call it a kind of tragedy. Actually, it is not a tragedy. It talks about the religious sacrifice of a great man. And Thomas Becket was very close to the King Henry II. Actually, Thomas Becket was earlier, he was the Chancellor of England, and he was very close friend of King Henry II. And what happened is, King Henry II appoints him as the Archbishop of Canterbury, expecting that he will give some favors when he wants to do something with the ecclesiastical world. So, actually, Thomas Becket and King Henry II were friends. But what happens after the appointment of Thomas into the Chancellor of England? Thomas Becket becomes a true religious ecclesiastical officer. Then what happens? King Henry's expectation was not meeting. So what happens? There was a strained relationship between Thomas Becket and King Henry II. So what happens? So Thomas goes in exile for nearly 7 years to France. And the play opens to the entry of Thomas Becket into England. So the main character is Thomas Becket, and another important character actually Horace. Horace is a group of women which comprises of the poor, common, and plain women of Canterbury. And throughout the play, it is a kind of evolution of their understanding. So, in the beginning, they doubt. Later, they understand the significance of Thomas Becket's martyrdom. And there was a messenger and the three priests. Actually, three priests are there, and their names are not given in the play. They are called first priest, second priest, third priest. So, the first, all these three priests have some. The first priest is characterized by his excessive mournfulness and worrying. He is always doubtful and worrying. And the second was pragmatism, he is practical. And the third one is full of patience. Patience is very important had only three temples. And Thomas Becket is shocked to see the fourth temple. I don't expect four, only three, he says at one moment. So again, the four temples are the inner personal condition of his own desires, his own temptation. So they are called temples. So temples are not coming from outside, the temples are coming from inside. So what happens again, four nights? And actually, the word very four is very close to Achilles. He writes four quarters. So the four pillars, something is staying only with four. He makes these four. Again, he uses four nights, but actually, these four nights have names. They are historical. Actually, we have names. Some Hugh D. Morville, William Tracy, like that. There are historical persons and they become characters. The beauty of the play is, though it seems to be a play, whatever happened was actually happening in real time. Again, there are two other characters, one is King Henry and another one is Pope. Both of them are appearing in the play in absentia. They don't appear on stage, but they are discussed, their words are discussed. Whatever happens because of these two people, though they were not on stage, they controlled the play. Thomas Becket's character is very beautifully personified and developed because Kieselring has a wonderful understanding of Christianity or whatever, the philosophy or whatever, what is martyrdom and all. So he beautifully develops a Christ-like character of Thomas Becket. Thomas Becket comes from an anonymous village, he was a politician. Turned a churchman. So what happens? Thomas Becket's beginning of life is different. It is represented in the first chapter. He was full of mirth and very needy. So later he turns out to be a father. So what happens? As a main character of the play is Thomas Becket, and he was wonderful clergy figure, a saintly figure. Actually, the play shows how he evolves into a saint. Actually, it is a kind of inner conflict. And in one point of time, he says, strife with the shadows. When four temples come into the scene, he says, strife with the shadows. So actually, the whole play is a kind of fight with temptation and being in the center. So being me restored. Again, he has the qualities of cruel. And so under the ideas, he's more than the tragedy. Actually, even in a conventional sense, it cannot be called as a tragedy because it is a kind of revolution of human thought. It is not a tragedy, it is a great achievement of moral force and the inner life. So, the tone of the play is not the tragedy. It is not the time to be, it is a time to rejoice. So, it is given in the kind of interlude, and he talks about that. Again, the weakness or flaw in the protagonist, and again, he behaves like a tragic hero. But in one sense, it is the moral category is not considered as a tragic. So, again, the central theme of modern category is martyrdom. Martyrdom is a very significant importance. It is of a very important significance because Jesus Christ was the first martyr of Christianity. So everybody wants to become Christ. It's the imitation of Christ. One who wants to become Christ, they should imitate Christ. So as I already told you, there should be some inner conflict, the strife with shadows. So what happens? The relation between the eternity and the presence. The relevance of martyrdom is a central idea. So what is the relevance? Why people are being killed for the sake of religious reasons? That was the main idea, as well as the question put forth before us. So, life of martyrdom is to be celebrated. The life of Thomas is to be celebrated because they don't die because of their own sins. They die for the sins of the others, the sins of the humankind. So what happens? It is a time to rejoice because they go and they reach the God and they will be celebrated. At one point of time, one tempter says, hold Thomas, hold. You hold the key to the heaven. So he becomes a saint. So becoming a saint is the greatest honor one can get for the human. So what happens? The relation between eternity and present, and there is a little religious thing. persuaded as a martyr, and who should be called out. And actually the very big question is whether Thomas is killed or not. So everybody is dying at one point of time. There is a clash. So that only he starts the title with Murder in the Cathedral, not Martyrdom at Cathedral. So the big question is whether Thomas is a martyr as or he is being murdered. So that was the biggest question. That we see at the interaction or encounter with the tempters. So at the last tempter only, Thomas decides not to act. He doesn't want to involve in the worldly life because nothing to do with this world. So he feels to be fixed with the will of God. And he surrenders his will to the will of God. So what happens? Again, a small attempt to go and make a murder becomes a kind of martyrdom. And at last, Thomas becomes a saint. So blending of divine inspiration and human cooperation. Actually, one point of time, there was a slight difference between Thomas's become a martyr or he is committing a suicide. So it was a suicide or a martyrdom. So that was another question. It was not a suicide because he is not leaning towards it and he is not running away from it. He surrenders himself to the will of God. He doesn't want to defend himself. At one point of time, he says, look, open the door. And if the church is open to all animals or anybody, any villain or rogue or